So far, we answered the question why Raman measurements are mainly done with visible instead of UV and infrared laser. Today, let's continue with the topic of laser selection.
We understand that Raman spectroscopy with a laser in 450 nanometer to 800 nanometer range is something of a sweet spot. Unfortunately, there is no one laser wavelength that is suitable for all applications, nor there is a major solution with a tunable laser. This means we must decide for one laser or choose multiple lasers for our Raman instrument, and each laser has its own strengths and limitations. For example, carbon nanotubes don't have fluorescence at short wavelengths, but are likely to get burned by near-infrared lasers. So of course, we can choose a blue laser for the best Raman signal, but as green laser will still provide similar results and is much more cost-effective. Most researchers are relying on 532 nanometer lasers. Of course, carbon nanotubes can still be investigated by a near-infrared laser, but you will have to turn down the laser power and extend the measurement time. For organic and colored samples, however, a 785 near-infrared laser offers a much more balanced performance with less fluorescence. Besides applicational requirements, the 532 and 785 nanometer laser are most used in Raman instruments because they are mature, reliable, and cost-effective. But concerning sensitivity, fluorescence effect, sample heating, and cost, the choice of laser remains difficult. Depending on the research task, users must find compromises, and a better balance might be found with a blue or red laser. Next time, we will see some other advantages of using visible laser, Raman microscopy.